To experimental, that's just a sampling of the type of films being showcased at the 5th annual DC Shorts Film Festival in Washington this year. And with us is the festival director, John Gann. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Mike.
I looked to see if there were puffy eyes or anything. These are the sleepless nights. Aren't they leading up to something like this? Or?
Yeah, well, a lot of sleepless nights. But this year we're really organized. I'm really excited. 102 films from 13 countries. We have more than 180 filmmakers coming from around the world. It's huge. We've become really probably the third largest short film festival in the world.
And I read somewhere where this is your best bang for your buck. If you do an entry fee, at least you know somebody's going to watch it and you're going to get some feedback, which I guess filmmakers really like.
Yeah, most film festivals, you apply, you send your money in, you send your film, and you never hear back. You hear no, and you don't know why. We actually give feedback. We have more than 120 judges who watch every film and write comments, and the filmmakers can actually log in after we make our decisions to find out why they didn't get in. And then they can make consultations with me, and I can talk to them about their film.
How daunting is this? I mean, are there some that just teeter and you're just like, geez, I wish we could get these in? Or
It's hard because we only have so many screenings. We're trying to show as many films as we can with as many different topics and genres as possible. It's difficult. I mean, there are some great films we weren't able to show this year. I wish we could do this for 3 weeks, but you know, 1 week is just plenty for now.
Let's talk about what we're looking at right now. Tell us about this one.
This is a great experimental piece. It's a story in which the right half is happening in reverse and the left half is happening forward motion, and it kind of meets in the middle at the end of the film. It's a beautiful piece. It's silent. It's really beautifully done.
Oh, I think I just got a headache thinking about that, but here's another one.
Oh, Hot Dog. Oh, Bill Plimpton, he was a famous animator, and it's a great little short film. It's actually being shown in our free kids screening that's on Saturday. A really funny film about a dog who wants to be a fireman.
I was thinking, what would happen if I asked the questions later and you answered them earlier in the interview, but that's not good. What about this one?
I can't see. Oh, this is Bloom. This is a great film about a security guard and a woman he meets on the job and a horrific incident at the lot with a set of dogs.
You know, what's interesting about this is you were telling me that shorts can be very, very short to as long as 40 minutes, but you generally don't accept 40-minute films, I guess.
We're showing stuff this year from 1 minute to 23 minutes. We try to keep things under 20 because that way we can show audiences in a 2-hour block as many films as possible. Most of the showcases have between 8 and 12 films.
Okay, so is it a roller coaster? Am I watching something depressing and then all of a sudden I'm laughing uproariously? Or?
Yeah, it's set up exactly like that. You're going to see a documentary, then probably followed by a funny little comedy, then a really heavy dramatic piece, an experimental piece. And in a 2-hour period, you can see all kinds of views from all over the world.
Tell the people how many movies you see in a year, because I was blown away when you told me. Well, just for this alone, you see a
ton. Well, this year we received about 750 entries for the festival. I watched probably 400 of the films. But, throughout the year, I probably watched close to 1,000 films.
Okay, and then be honest, out of those 400, how many were excruciating, like a root canal?
Oh, a lot. Probably about 100.
You're probably gentle, though, when you do give them the feedback. Well,
if they're really that bad, I might actually call the filmmaker and talk to them about it and say, what were you thinking, and did I miss something? And sometimes I do miss things, So I'm not, I'm a film director myself. I'm not the brightest guy in the world, and sometimes I just don't get the point of view of another director.
Yeah, but if you miss it, the audience is likely to miss it as well.
Most likely, yeah.
So tell me, if people were interested, which I'm sure they are, and they want to come out, when can they come, and how do they purchase tickets, all of that?
The competition portion of the weekend is Thursday through Saturday this week, and tickets are on sale at dcshorts.com. We're repeating the entire festival again from Sunday through Wednesday, and then next Thursday is our Best of DC Shorts. We're going to have four shows showing all the award winners.
And then Friday, you sleep for the next 3 weeks.
And then Friday, I sleep until like Tuesday,
John, thanks so much for coming
in
this morning. Certainly appreciate it. Let's check in with Angie, see how the traffic's moving.